Prime Minister, 2 years now in power. Those who were watching you 2 years ago still remember the promises you made about clamping down on corruption, mismanagement, unemployment, foreign debt, creating 10 million jobs, providing low-cost housing, sophisticated education services and health services. For many people, by the way, Mr. Prime Minister, you haven't so far delivered on those promises. Why?
Hashim, think about any economy in the world which face similar problems what Pakistan faced. Huge deficits, external and internal. Mm-hmm. And then the power sector in serious trouble. No country can immediately snap its finger and everything, the reforms take place. It's a struggle. Moving the economy, reforming the economy is not an overnight thing. It takes time because, you know, the whole mindset, more incentive structure, mm-hmm. and then you have to change the way government works, ease of doing business, incentivizing the right structures, the right sectors. It takes time. But in my opinion, in these 2 years, Pakistan has moved into the right direction. You know, in the dream world, in fairy tales, there are these quick solutions. You have a magic wand and a society changes. In real life, when you want to pick your country up and change direction, it's a struggle. I do not want my country to always keep boring for its existence. Mm-hmm. Pakistan has to change the structure of raising your revenues. It takes reforms. And then cutting down your expenditure, what we've done. Corruption is one of the biggest killers in the society. Today, there is no mega corruption scandal in Pakistan because at the top level, we've controlled it. Problem is still we have corruption low down the levels, which is again going to be a struggle. We need to take a lot of steps eventually to control corruption at all levels. But it's a struggle. It's not going to happen quickly. And so reason why we have not been able to clamp down on corruption is because those who come into power and make money, using the power to make money, have never been held accountable. And so this is the first time in our history that the powerful are being held accountable.